Hey guys, how's it going? It is Clary Berry here with the Aries horoscope for the 13th through the 20th. So, on the 13th, we have Mars going into Sagittarius in your 9th house and Mercury going to Capricorn in your 10th house. Do a walking meditation each day for the next week. Okay, gotta get some of that energy out. So, yeah, with our Mars in Sagittarius for the next few weeks or so, in our 9th house, we're definitely gonna be feeling like exploring, broadening those horizons. Just everything you do is gonna be based off of this drive, you know, to grow and to expand your, not necessarily your own self, but some sort of enterprise that you are connected with here, and expand, you know, this vision of what you have attained in life. Okay. You really feel like you're getting somewhere in life, and you're really motivated, I think, at this time to achieve like everything you've ever wanted, basically to achieve something that you've been working hard for. Okay. And it's really, you know, wrapped up in your confidence. You're very optimistic about this. And again, you're going to do whatever it takes. You're going to, it's like uncover things, get to the bottom of it, and you won't stop until you have mastered, you know, again, kind of this aspect of whatever it is that you're wanting to learn about and learning, growing, and just broadening your horizons regarding. Okay. So your Mercury moving into Capricorn in your 10th house, this has a lot to do with, you know, your long-term goals, and you're really able to do some really good long-term planning during the next few weeks, starting this week. Okay. So yeah, there's definitely, again, some things that you're wanting in your life that you're going to be able to make major moves on. You're going to be able to stay. It's like, if you're walking on this tightrope to your goal, you are, things can get a little wobbly sometimes, but you are balanced. You're staying on the goals. You're doing what needs to be done, and you can feel yourself. You can feel this positivity of you getting closer and closer to whatever it is that you want during, you know, again, moving from Sagittarius season into Capricorn season. So again, the mental, you know, energy is high. There's good emotional energy that makes your mental energy even more fun and fiery and passionate and better. So yeah, looking for a very spicy, bold, fun time here. And again, that energy is going to be with us for the next few weeks. The 14th through the 15th, we have the moon in Taurus in your second house. So you're going to be wanting to surround yourself with nice things, and just have a very comforting, like, for your own emotional sake, I think at this time, allow yourself to have the very best in life in all ways, whether it's food, whether it's drink, whether it's decorations, clothes, you deserve it. Okay. And whereas we don't want to be too superficial, sometimes it can really be a sign and a symbol and really a way to raise our vibration. If our vibration has gotten low or gotten off track, or we just need a nice pick me up, it is a good benefit, you know, of comfort and nice things, whether it's a nice massage, you know, whatever luxurious things, you know, that you could possibly think of. I would say let yourself have them on the 14th and the 15th, if at all possible. So the 16th through the 18th, we have the moon in Gemini in your third house. We are looking at learning something new here, probably at work, probably regarding work, maybe regarding money. But you're sharing, you might be doing like work presentations here, or really keeping the boat afloat at work. I'm just getting this leadership energy, and the more that you can learn about, you know, what you're working about, it's just going to turn out better for you. You're going to accomplish more by delving into the ins and outs, you know, like learning what's going on with the company sort of energy, and doing the analytics and all of that. And then sharing again, you can't just learn everything and not share it. You've got to learn it. And then again, you've got to share it, give it out. And you've got to kind of get people in a place, almost like you're motivating others at work too. So again, the more learning you can do, whether it's learning about how to motivate people, learning how to be a leader, learning more about your craft. This day and age, there's so much to learn about every single subject, even more than 10, 20 years ago. So never stop learning. Lifelong learner here. That's going to be kind of the energy there. So on the 19th and the 20th, we have Cancer, Moon in Cancer in your fourth house. So you might be feeling kind of a little bit more. Okay, so it's like almost like you might get to a point of burnout where you've done so much and you've just given all you can, and now you need a restart, you need a reset. I totally love this card, and I love it for Aries in particular. It's just like, even the cups, it has a little flame. You know, this is the Ace of Chalices here, so it's the Ace of Cups, and but we still have all this water, but we still have our flame. So our flame is not going out. We're not letting our flame go out right now. We're going to allow ourselves to have a little peaceful reset. You know, again, this is part of moving forward. This is part of the next step, you know, and the next step is going to be more fun and outgoing, you know, after this. And it's like, during the 19th and 20th, we might just want to kind of, again, catch our breath, take it easy after maybe some of, again, social engagements we've been going to, or again, if we hit some kind of burnout physically, give yourself rest, give yourself peace to recycle. Because again, in the next few days after this, after the 19th and 20th, then you're going to have more opportunity to shine, more opportunity to have fun. And this is just to allow yourself to kind of soften, to have a little relaxation, and it's gonna just help you. Okay, so stay steady, don't overdo it. You've got to keep this party mode, this awesome vibe going, not just for this week, but I feel like even after that. So again, steady pace, a little bit of shadow work now and then is never gonna be a bad thing, but just keep on being you. Keep on sharing the positivity. Keep on sharing your abundance, your optimism. It's perfect. And you're going to be able to, it's like with your Mars and Sagittarius, again, you're able to motivate people. You have the optimism to get people excited right now. So use that, run with it. During walking, I can see you getting new ideas, how to share, how to grow, how to inspire. And this is a really poignant time for you, a really passionate time. So run with it, feel it, love it, live it. Take care. I'll talk to you soon. Many blessings. Bye.